Hi, my name's Mike Mangini, and I play drums in the band Dream Theater. I want to make a connection between how practicing with it as a developmental tool really does transform me and affects me here on this drum set that I use with my band and personally. As you can see, I have to reach pretty far to hit a lot of this stuff. Practicing on pads just doesn't do the trick. And with the Gen 16, I can actually get the motions without horrifying everybody in the neighborhood, or even in my own house, or even myself, and going deaf. I mean, I can practice with those things and absolutely have no repercussions from winding up and whacking the cymbal, as opposed to this setting where, unless I have hearing protection, I'll be in big trouble. So the Gen 16 is really important for me physically, especially as just a developmental tool, never mind the sound aspect. And it's really effective for me. As I progress in my warm-up, I go from just getting the motion to wanting to start to fix it, to get it more in time, and to maybe even start to listen to the musical implications of it. But I have to gravitate towards that. With this particular setup of mine, the hi-hats are very, very, very helpful for me to get my leg motion, a full leg motion, like this. Two things are, number one, it's not loud. My windows are open. Number two, I can't really get that motion on my Dream Theater kick because I'm sitting too high so I can reach everything. This is really helpful for me to do this here. I like to work on large, odd numbers because they keep me focused and give me time. They give my body time to really feel what's going on. Let me give you an example. I'll click my sticks every 19 hits, okay? I'll click them every 17 hits. These larger patterns help me stay focused. And, well, I need to really get my whole body involved and start to fix everything. So what I do is I just play those lengthy patterns, simply keeping the pulse with both hands, moving around, using my whole body. Let me just give you an example. I'll use a smaller number so it doesn't take so long, like 11. It's odd, switches sides, and it keeps me busy. As you can see, I'm moving my body, and it really helps my legs to feel all the possibilities, especially when I switch from these cable hi-hats to my pedals, because now I'm getting to the point that, well, I can use the technique to play very, very strongly with the bass drums, which I have to do with my band. I have to have a lot of slap and attack, or I'm not heard. But check out the difference in velocity and sound. I increased tremendously with velocity, and all I did was flex my hip flexors and bring my toes up the pedal. That's all that I did. I didn't start hitting any harder necessarily. So the technique gained while I use hi-hats with moving my body around tremendously accelerates my ability to develop balance, strength, and velocity with my feet. Well, as you can see from the use of the Gen 16 in my world, it's really going to help transform me and help me grow, not only as a musician personally, no matter how I use my skills, but it'll help transform how I play the drums in my band as well. So I'll have more control of the sound. Now, given that there are so many possibilities for a drummer and so many things to do, so many areas to, you know, to grow, I just can't see how somebody wouldn't choose to have more crayons in their crayon box. Why wouldn't you want to have more tools and have more possibilities in there? And the Gen 16 offers me that. And that's why I developed my chops as well. If I don't have the chops, I can't have the gig. You know, there was a time when orchestras existed a long time ago. If, as a musician, you couldn't play the part, you can't be in the band. So chops are not a bad thing. Colors are not a bad thing. The tools are not bad in and of themselves. I'd rather have more of them so I can express more ideas. And the Gen 16 clearly now has helped me develop some more physical skills. It's helped me develop some more possibilities with sound. And it's also given me the option to fuse it in or not, or use it as a standalone or not. And I just can't see why I wouldn't choose that. Why not have a bigger box of crayons? It's just more fun.